In those days, everything was new.
The most important thing was the music.
We played the best of everything.
It was really magical. It was a great energy.
So rock and roll was what it was all about.
At the time, we were just happy to be on the ship playing the music.
Stiamo andando ad Amsterdam perché domani ci sarà l'attesissimo raduno annuale dei grandi protagonisti della radio pirata degli anni 60 e 70. Tra l'altro quest'anno ricorre anche il 50° anniversario di Radio Caroline, che è la radio a cui si sono ispirati per un film che probabilmente avrete visto, cioè I Love Radio Rock. Le radio pirata erano le radio che, per aggirare i limiti imposti dallo Stato inglese che vietava a qualsiasi emittente che non fosse la BBC di trasmettere sul suolo nazionale, irradiavano il segnale da una nave a oltre 3 miglia dalla costa. La prima radio pirata inglese, ormai passata alla storia e celebrata anche nel film commedia I Love Radio Rock, è stata Radio Caroline, nata il 28 marzo 1964. Il proprietario è Ronan O'Reilly, all'epoca 24enne, e il primo DJ a parlare ai suoi microfoni quel giorno fu lui. Il suo nome è Christopher Moore. Aprì le trasmissioni con queste parole: "This is Radio Caroline on 199, your all day music station."
This is Radio Caroline on 199, your all day music station.
319 Radio Caroline.
Il Radio Day si tiene in Olanda dal 1977. La nazione nord-europea è molto legata alla tradizione delle radio pirata, perché qui ne nacquero molte in quegli anni. La più famosa è Radio Veronica, e anche Radio Caroline rimase ancorata al largo delle sue coste per 2 anni. Ci stiamo dirigendo verso l'Hotel Casa, il luogo dove si terrà l'evento per cui oggi siamo qua. Incontreremo i DJ che hanno rivoluzionato la radio in Europa. In occasione del Radio Day convergono letteralmente da tutto il mondo i DJ protagonisti delle radio pirata degli anni 60 e 70. I DJ che vedete qui oggi vengono da Canada, Messico, Stati Uniti e Australia, oltre che da tutta Europa.
We were pirates.
Noi abbiamo scelto 2 tra i più prestigiosi DJ dell'epoca per farci raccontare la Radio Caroline dei 60s. Il primo è Tony Prince, classe 1944. Lui ha lavorato a Radio Caroline dal 1965 al 1967, per passare poi a Radio Luxembourg, di cui è stato anche direttore dei programmi. Chi meglio di lui conosce la realtà delle radio di quegli anni?
Saluto italiano, it's Tony Prince, your royal regal rockin' ruler here.
Hey, good evening everybody, this is your royal ruler Tony Prince.
It was a wonderful experience and we really had a great team. And when I say team, it was guys who ate together, you know, cried together, got drunk together, partied together, and that's why the pirate DJs were different than any other radio station DJ teams, because they lived together. They had cabins next door to each other.
Altro prestigioso DJ di quell'epoca è Johnny Walker.
Johnny Walker.
Okay, here we go. 3 hours of the best music you ever heard.
Johnny Walker è stato a Radio Caroline dal 1966 al 1967. Il suo show serale aveva uno share dell'86%, il che vuol dire che per ogni 100 persone che ascoltavano la radio nei territori raggiunti da Radio Caroline, 86 ascoltavano lui.
Johnny Walker here until midnight. At midnight tonight it's the Weird Band, Carl Mitchell.
Caroline!
Great thing was, all you could do was think about your radio program. There was, you know, if you're on shore, on land, you might go to the pub, you might go to the cinema, spend time with your family or whatever, but being on the ship, all you could think about and concentrate on was your radio show that day. So that's why it was really good radio, and for listeners, not only did they hear the sound of free radio and great music, they could also tune into the family living together on board, and DJs would come in on each other's programs, occasionally the captain or the cook would come in the studio and and say a few words to Dutch listeners and things like that. So it was very much a family atmosphere that only could happen on a ship, really.
3 hours of great music ahead. From now to midnight, got two brilliant soul songs at the 10 o'clock turn-on coming up later on.
The most important thing was the music. You look at the charts of the big hits that happened in 1965, 66, 67, some of the greatest records that have ever been made. So the great thing was just to keep playing those great music.
I guess I'll just take your glasses.
You could try to imagine hearing those records for the very first time. Beatles, Strawberry Fields, Rolling Stones, Satisfaction, Jeff Beck, Hi-Ho, Silver Lining, the Beach Boys, Barbara Ann. They're great records, but when you heard them for the first time, nobody in the world had ever heard them before, and we were the guys who were able to play them to the people first. It must have been amazing hearing those records.
Radio Caroline era una radio pirata, ma le regole erano ferree. Ogni DJ passava 2 settimane in mare e una a terra, e sulla nave non erano ammesse donne, droghe o eccessi alcolici. Per divertirsi, i DJ dovevano aspettare di tornare a terra.
We used to work 2 weeks on board the ship, and then the tender, the little ship, fishing boat came out and took us ashore, and we had a week in England. I'd go down to London with the Emperor Roscoe. We shared a room together in London, and it was the 60s, and there were more girls coming through that room than there were waiters, you know? It was just an incredible time to be a DJ in London, in Carnaby Street, you know, with the Beatles happening. It was just a great, great time.
It's been a
After a week of partying on shore, you would then go back to the ship, and you would be very happy to get back to the ship because you were tired. You were fatigued.